straight out of Moonlight. Yeah. Just a bunch of John Deere junkies getting funky to some old hang. Nothing been stuck in the mud that we can't hook up to a rusty chain. And the sun will in the rain. Yeah, it's the kind of thing. You know we're straight out of that dirty south, dirty roads. Nobody got no money. Got them signed up pickup trucks whistling at them from the country. Yes, sir. Straight out of Moonlight, straight out of Moonlight. Woo! You know we're straight out of that dirty south, dirty roads. Nobody got no money. Got them pickup trucks whistling at them from the country. Yes, sir. You know we're straight out of that long week working now. Everybody wanna party all night long. Bonfire on the back 40 in the middle of nowhere. Nobody going home tonight till we're straight out of Moonlight. Straight out of Moonlight.
Thank you, Larry. Brandon Gauden, along with Charles Davis here in the booth. We are set for a spectacular draft champions matchup and some spectacular talent on your screen right now. Let's not waste any more time. Let's get down to the field for kickoff. And it's the birth of a new club as we're underway in Draft Champions. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They go play action here on first down. They'll lock it with a grab over the middle. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
Off the play fake, Mariota on the move to his left. On the catch, it's Andre Johnson. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
That's the type of play there that puts a defense in a stress. Marcus Mariota on the run. You don't know whether he's going to take it downfield or throw the footballs we just saw there. And boy, was he accurate with that one.
And you know, the Oregon coaches offered him a scholarship without ever seeing him start a game because they saw him in camp. They saw plays like that, offered him.
He didn't start very much in high school, but he started a lot once he got to Oregon. Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Looking for Lockett, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Tyvon Branch. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. That can be a downside of putting together a team in Draft Champions Week 1. It's early. You might have some of these mistakes.
You're exactly right, because it does take time to build chemistry, trust, right? Understanding where guys are going to be. And I think that's what led to the interception. They just don't know each other well enough yet. That should build up as the season goes on.
Calling a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they give up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
C.J. Anderson. And all the way in. Touchdown, San Diego. All right, Larry, thank you. It is indeed time for a draft champions matchup in what is set to be a great draft champions matchup. In the booth, I'm Brandon Gaudin with Charles Davis, and these guys should have a huge impact on the outcome of this game. They're ready to roll. We're ready to roll. Let's roll. Two teams here amped and ready for football, and off we go in week two of Draft Champions. It's a short kick taken near the 18. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. They come up in an offset eye. First carry for the 5'10 Pro Bowler, LaDainian Tomlinson. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
One of the toughest things for an offensive lineman to learn is the ability to get in space and hit people who are moving targets. And linebackers are not easy ones to hit because they know how to move, juke, and make you miss. And that's exactly what he did on that play. A nice play for the defense.
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. The tight end, Jermaine Gresham, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Get ready. Second and 10. It's Palmer again. He's going to loft one deep left side here. It's caught at the 10. Touchdown, 49ers. Mike Evans, 59 yards. And the Niners have taken the early lead. Not a bad way to start it.
And I think that that was part of their script, because so many teams script their opening possessions, and whether it's just that possession or even deeper into the half, sometimes it's 15 to 30 plays. That had to be one in there where they call a shot play. Go for the big one, and they got it done.
That's fielded in the end zone. And last year, that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year, he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee, and that's at the 25. In the backfield is Anderson. Now they'll run it on the toss. It'll go as a gain of 10 there, and the Chargers are going to have a first down.
But we just saw him run the football really effectively there with three tight ends in the game. And any defensive coordinator, when they see that set, if they can get more bodies out onto the field, not more than 11, of course, but bigger bodies to combat what they're going to do, because that's a run-heavy formation. Those guys are out there to block 9 times out of 10. And in this case, they did it really successfully.
And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is back off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find a
touchdown. 49ers. LaDainian Tomlinson, 37 yards. And the 49ers add on to their lead. Thank you very much, Larry Ridley. I'm Brandon Gauden with Charles Davis. We are ready for this draft champions matchup as you get a quick peek at some of the stars in today's game. We're ready to go. Let's get down to kickoff. The getting to know each other process is over. Time to get down to it. And we're off in week 3 of Draft Champions. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Able to get away.
That's why you keep the legs churning.
Now a carry for the former Michigan State man, Le'Veon Bell. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13.
But when it comes to the running game, the New England Patriots, they're one of the few teams in the NFL that I don't think care much about balancing things out.
Last year, to your point, fifth in passing yardage, number 30 in the run game.
What they want to do each and every week is make a game plan based on their opponent, not so much their own personnel, and try to attack that way.
Now Brady going up top, and that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, he pulled it in. A big play there for the Patriots, 32 yards.
I know they had good coverage downfield, but you have to wonder, on third and long like that, how does that happen that they can get that far downfield and complete a pass? You got to guard the sticks, understand where you are, so it's almost like someone fell asleep at the switch, and now that the play's been completed, they've got to dust themselves off on defense, pick it up, and figure out how to not let that happen again.
Brady again here on second and 10. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the veteran, Brian Arakpo. And he returns it into enemy territory, down to the 45-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive.
Just a bunch of poor boys, daddy's girls, children of the cornfield, trying to turn a shift job into a dollar bill. We wear the muddy boots, stay true to how we're raised, ain't nothing about us fake. You know we're straight out of that dirty south, dirty roads, nobody got no money, got them signed up pickup trucks, whistling at them from the country. Yes, sir. You know we're straight out. John Deere jockeys getting funky, this and old hang. Nothing been stuck in the mud that we can't hook up to rusty chain in the sun or in the rain. Yeah, it's the kind of thing. You know we're straight out of that dirty south, dirty roads. Nobody got no money, got them signed up pickup trucks, whistling at them from the country. Yes, sir.
All right, Larry, hope everyone is settled in for a great Draft Champions contest. Here, lucky to witness it, I'm Brandon Gaughan with Charles Davis. These guys that you see on your screen, they won't be witnessing. They will be participating in what should be an excellent game. Let's get down to the field. It's time for kick. Here's the Steelers kick team as they'll boot this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25.
Detroit! Detroit!
Bryant, the lone receiver, left.
Over!
On first, they'll throw with Elway. His first pass is incomplete. Dez Bryant, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. Little trouble thus far on their opening drive as they come up on a third and 11. Now it's Elway. He completes it to Bryant. Dez Bryant with nothing but green grass ahead of him. And all the way in. Touchdown, San Diego. 76 yards. And the Chargers have taken a first quarter lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it. Get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible? Or was it just a...
This is intercepted. Picked off by Quan Alexander. So they're able to get the six, but they cannot get in on the two-point conversion. The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Three and a half to go, first quarter. Goff on first down. Screen play, Anderson. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. A good convergence there defensively, only a yard, and it's second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
A good pick up there of 20 yards.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
On second and 10, gone. And that's off the mark, incomplete. He was trying to find Marvin Jones that time, and it'll bring up third down. Here's Goff. Out left side here to Bryant. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
All right, here we go. All right, now, look at 56.
Play action. It's gone. He'll buy some time right. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Torn back across his body. Picked off by the linebacker, Vontaze Burfict. Now the Chargers offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. They fake the give. Now Elway. It's caught by Quincy Enunwa. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play-action pass, and completing it.
In the backfield is Anderson. Elway. And Bryant's got it over the middle. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
Pass complete, but no gain.
No yards.
Yeah.
So you file that as unsuccessful.
Yeah, you do, don't you? Except on the stats, throwing the ball.
Get a completion.
You get a catch.
Yeah.
But still,
no yardage.
Okay.
Anderson looking to find a lane, but he can't. Reined in at the line of scrimmage. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down. They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
So on fourth down, on is the punter, Pat O'Donnell, to kick it away. much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other fire. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better. It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And on second and 10 now. Now it's Goff off the bootleg. Being chased out left. Thrown across his body and it's intercepted. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line. So out come the Chargers. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Bryant, the lone receiver, left. Again on second and 10, it's Elway. And this is incomplete. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Play action. Elway. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. It's Steeler football to begin quarter number two. They've got it first and 10 following the fumble recovery. Fumble recovery. Rush coming and he's taken down. J.J. Watt in there to bring him down for a loss of 7.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
He completes it to Bryant, and he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line.
When I watched Jared Goff on tape at Cal, I saw a guy who wasn't just a dart thrower. You know, a lot of people said, ah, he's perfect for the West Coast offense. I always thought he could do a little bit more, and that was the reason why. He can push it downfield. He has a good, strong arm.
That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal. First and goal here from the 2. Here's Anderson, and he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. We've become so accustomed to it, you sort of take it for granted.
You really do, but he is so good that every team in his division, every year, is trying to make...
And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. Oh, very close to a turnover there in the end zone. Well, interceptions have been a problem in this one. If he could have gotten his feet down here, it would have been another.
Would have been a huge one. They've had a great game taking the ball away. Thought they had another one, just unable to get those cleats inbounds.
And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion as we just saw there, that's winning football.
And no hesitation about this decision here. Confidently, they're going to go for this. Fourth and goal from the 3. Here we go. On. Guys, man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Dez Bryant, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Steelers are an extra point away from taking the lead. And he puts it through. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And this This will not work out. The Chargers able to recover.
A second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team.
Dez Bryant with nothing but green grass ahead of him. And all the way in. Touchdown, San Diego. Dez Bryant with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Chargers are going to retake the lead. And he puts this one through as the lead moves to 13-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. Gone. He's going to air one out. Oh, jumping over. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Help me out, partner. Was that incomplete?
That was on a deep ball to Dez.
And that's a surprise. The way he attacks the football in the air, it's always surprising to me when he doesn't complete a pass like that.
Out to his left. Out left side here to Bryant. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot and they connected.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. J.J. Watt coming hard that time. He's able to run him down for a loss of 12. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They'll fake the give. Now Goff. He's going to launch this thing way down. And that's caught inside the 30. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Dez Bryant with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Steelers are an extra point away from taking the lead. And this one through the uprights and good. Here's the Steelers kick team as they'll boot this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The Chargers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football. And you're holding it.
And a Steeler pressure too much here. He's going down. Quan Alexander leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of 6. Second down, sacked by the defense. What type of pressure will they bring here on third? We'll see.
Hurry up, here we
go. Now Elway on third and long. And here the hookup good to Victor Cruz. No move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and 5.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way in. Touchdown, San Diego. Quincy Anunua, 62 yards. And the Chargers have once again taken the lead. And that'll make this a six-point game. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And this doesn't work. The Steelers recover it. The risk-reward of the onside kick, when you don't get it, the risk comes out to play, and here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything, because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them, and field position leads you to that type of play calling, and whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things, now they've given up that type of field position, the advantage is switched to their opponent.
Now a first down throw, gone. Screenplay, Anderson. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to do.
And this is caught inside the five. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
So they tie it on the last play of the second quarter. Now the PAT will give them the lead.
Yeah, and how about that extra little jolt that they'll feel when the ball goes through the post? Carry that to the locker room with them and feel like, okay, we've got something good going here now, guys.
Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Fielded about a yard deep. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively.
He's got a man complete. They give him a gain of 38.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
It's caught by Bryant. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Looked like the screen pass was taken away there, and that was a nice job of improvising, but it's not normal. Usually when the screen pass is taken away, you're taught to just throw the ball at the ground and defeat it.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by the linebacker, Vontaze Burfict. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now, can the offense do what they wanted to do at the half, which is find those weaknesses and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Plus like that at just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
On second down, Anderson. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. And a tackle there by Quan Alexander. And quickly, they get to the line.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
And on display right there, the arm that made John Elway a lot of money.
And that's going to leave a mark, because when he throws it with that much.
But when this ball's tipped and intercepted, picked off by Jaleel Adai. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Now a play fake, and it's gone. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Anthony Barr coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of eight. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Off play action. Here's Goff. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. And the Chargers coming out of the field now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Cruz has it over the middle. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. And just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Quan Alexander. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game.
And now here is another interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. And now San Diego getting set to go. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? And they're going to hurry back to the line now. And a nice pitch and catch to pick up the reception against man coverage.
Both of them read how much yardage they needed, figured what they had to do, and were able to beat the man coverage.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get hit at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. Only a yard of the pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine. On third down, Elway. He completes it to Bryant. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Dez Bryant from 19 yards away. And the Chargers are going to take the lead.
And that third counter there gives them the lead, and it's obvious they've needed everything that he's given them today. The three touchdowns, that's impressive, but without them, they're not winning this game.
And he will dive into the end zone, and the two-point conversion is successful. This doesn't work. The Steelers recover it. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that. Just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics will tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't you?
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
Play action. It's gone. Backing up. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. It's a loss of two, now third down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Here's Goff. A dump off to Anderson. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at. So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on fourth and eight. Goff. Deep drop. He's going to sling this deep. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And tough starting field position here. And they'll try to fire up the running game with C.J. Anderson. And he's able to get this across the 10 before being taken down. Back now here on EA Sports. It's Charger football, and they've got the lead as well as we begin the fourth quarter. They run again on first down. Anderson. And strong running there gets this up over the 15-yard line. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. And this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line. The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
That's so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
And they're going to speed things up here. To throw is Elway. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down. Second down now after the incompletion.
Here we go.
Second and 10. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Quan Alexander in there to sack him for a loss of six.
Partner, I know the ball security is preached like crazy, but every now and then you've got to know when to get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was third and 10 versus third and much longer as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling and the pressure you might expect to face on the very next down. Had to throw the ball away and save the yardage. He didn't get it done.
And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Elway will throw, and Bryant's got it over the middle. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That one good for 21 yards. And they're able to...
Just acting. met, but we're acting like we go back. It's 3 a.m., we ain't done yet, trying our best to make it last.